seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Fight!
Ah!
know you click somewhere in the front. You might have you click.
So let's say this one is like asleep master.
Okay.
You left.
Okay.
Okay, format that. Okay. No. Format.
Huh?
Can I do this? How do you set the font type? Send the font type to Vartana.
Wait.
For the whole spreadsheet.
Oh yes. Whoa, there is not much options.
Oh no. Well, go see what it is trying to tell you. It's trying to tell you, no, those are tabs. Those are tabs, hold on. Fonts on this. Will be on the home front. On the home front.
Oh.
That's where the font.
Oh yeah, that's where. Oh yeah, it's
if
okay.
You do, if you set it right now, it is going to only apply to that cell that you select.
So select everything.
How would you select everything?
Huh?
No. That's going to change.
Uh-oh.
You dragged and copied. That's going to change, right? Okay. How do you select everything? What it was saying. Click the upper left corner of the spreadsheet. Okay.
Upper left corner?
Which is this one right here, upper left corner.
Oh.
If you click here, the whole spreadsheet gets selected.
Oh, okay.
Get it?
I did not know.
Okay, so go click there.
And then you can go to home and then you can go home and then change.
Search for the font.
That changed.
Now next. So which one is the right choice here?
Up this one. Yes.
Where your cell is, if you put a split, both vertical and horizontal splits right there. Okay, stop jumping. Okay, here, number 5. How do you add a column of numbers?
Auto sum? With subtotal? Or both of them are correct.
I'm going to give you a number. So I'm going to remove this bit first. If you click again, then this bit goes off. Okay? So here, let me see. As the mask goes out, 15 numbers. See that 12 hours, see that 18 hours. And see that 12 hours. You want to put a lot of that, how do you do it?
Awesome.
First select a cell at the end of the list of numbers. Click on the data tab and select subtotal.
Yeah.
Is that true? Or first select a cell at the end of the list. Click the formula. What is it saying?
May Microsoft Excel cannot determine which row in your list or selection contains column labels which are required for the schematic. What is
you want to do subtotals and he doesn't know what he wants to subtotal.
Oh, you have to select what you want to subtotal.
But you don't need to subtotal right now, you just need a total. Auto sum, you just need auto sum. know what happened now? You drag. You select, no doubt. Okay? Select the ones you want to sum. Select that. Then you go to home. In home itself, you will find a tab for auto sum.
Oh, okay. Well, you know, the interface is very different from from the old one that you used in.
When you see auto sum, it is going to apply that formula saying sum, and then it's going to give a range. So what is it giving? It's giving
E5
a range of to E5 cell, E5 to E8. Okay, so those are use of formulas and ranges that you will know more. Okay, let's go here.
Well, what happens if you just like type in the formula and just.
Also required. Let's try
you
that.
Just type.
Can you type in the term formula?
And then you
say equal to. No. Formula only starts with equal to.
Equal to.
Sum.
Sum.
Open bracket. Yeah. And then.
E5.
You basically can click right now. Instead of typing, you can go there. Click the first shell. Wait. Where are you clicking? Why are you clicking there? Click the cell. No. Delete. Instead of typing, I was saying you can click. Right. Click number 15. Not that. Not that. First row. First value. Okay. And now. Wait. First cell. Now put a range. Range is put as a colon always.
Colon?
Yeah. Now put the last one on that. Click the last one. Okay. Now close the bracket. Does the same thing. It puts the same formula. Go back to the cell, you can see the formula. Same formula that you put in AutoSum, it is the same thing. It's kind of, you know, does it for you. Okay? So that's a sum. Like you have sum, you can do what? You can count, you can give the same thing. Count. There are four of the items. You can give average. Min, you can do min, max, average, all the cell functions. Remember this? Min, max, average, all of them. You should be able to do A, B, and average. Here.
Average.
Well,
min?
That's an error. When you get that, that means the formula didn't resolve. So you come in here and say average. Double click on that, it's going to give you the average. Get it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so now go back, test your basic knowledge. How do you add a column of numbers? AutoSum or subtotal are both answers correct? No, it's the AutoSum. It just now did AutoSum. Don't guess. Go to the Excel spreadsheet and see. See what is there in the data tab. Yeah. Go to the data tab. Wait, don't delete. Right now this is right click. It said about the data tab. Go to the data tab. Is there a delete somewhere here?
There's no delete.
So in data tab is not there. Go back to the test. Next one. Yeah. So data tab is not there. Delete button from the cells tab. Is there a cells tab? Go back to the cell spreadsheet and see for a cells tab. You have a cells tab? You don't have a cells tab. Over then. There is delete, yeah.
Don't
select the whole row delete. Go back to Excel, go back to one can add a nice visual effect to an Excel spreadsheet. How can you change the color of a cell's background? Okay, all the names, put them in a blue-black background, and all the numbers, put them in an orange background. Go do that in Excel. Names, blue background. Not only one. Why are you selecting only one? If you drag that, how do you select multiple rows? Tell me that. How do you select multiple rows? Hold shift button. Hold shift button. And then? Yeah. Okay. Got it. Okay. Hold shift button again. Okay. Now you can go to coloring. Home tab. Yeah. Paint. 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 Yeah, that's the background. Fill color.
Huh.
You want.
That's terrible.
You want to get. Light blue.
What? You can change the text color.
Yeah, text color also you can change.
Yeah, you can also
change the numbers to a different color. Select that. Yes.
Oh. Change the color
to orange.
To red.
What are all these other things? These are justification.
Yeah,
context.
I know that.
Do you know them?
I know that.
These are.
I know that
center,
central line, and then there's
alignment,
and then right alignment.
You know about conditional formatting in Excel?
Huh?
Conditional formatting helps you to highlight things that you want to check. Let's say, for example, you want to highlight all of the values. Okay, so you would go here. So let's say here, there are two values that are duplicate. See? It just highlights that.
Oh.
These two values are duplicate. For conditional formatting. This is for cells. Here's, in the home tab, it gives you cell deleting cells, deleting rows, deleting sheet. Do you know sheet? Sheet is, let me tell you this, a workbook is a collection of multiple sheets. Okay? This is a sheet one. It's a default. This plus sign can be used to click another and add another tab onto it.
Okay.
So that
I need to vacuum.
This is for adding the tab, and then at the cells tab, there is also, you can right click here, it gives you option to delete tab also. Delete. Gives you option to move or copy also. You can move or copy. What are you saying? Get back here. Come on, 12 questions, complete this. No, kneel down.
Kneel down.
Color can add a nice visual Excel spreadsheet. Effect to the visual, by a visual effect.
You select your text, you go.
You select the color cells,
and then you go to
click the page layout tab and select colors under the themes tab. Is that what you're going to do?
On the home page. How do you add a title to your title?
You can insert that.
Title. Insert. This one's definitely not correct.
Go ahead and add a title. Go back to the Excel.
I know
how to
add a title.
Go, do that. Add a title.
Insert.
What do you want?
human foot.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
Width or a low height?
I know, too. Or you can just click and drag the cells.
Yeah, so which one is it? Which option is it?
Click the margins. What is that? Well, does format mean erase?
Format doesn't mean erase. Format is your formatting. Tell me first if you use
spell check. Do they have a spell check feature?
Excuse. I'm gonna go check. Google me.
Home? Yes, spell it. Yeah, it's in review. Yeah, spell it. What's in the review tab? You have a large Spanish. What did you have to do under the view tab? Date. This thing is find and select. Yes, find the binoculars. Find. Have a sample. I'm clearly not an expert. I know how to use if I was forced to use Excel, I could use it.
very interesting to learn. A lot of things you can do with Excel.
But it's not useful for me until I have a ton of things to do.
Have you learned cascaded style sheets?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yes.
This is the basic skills that you need anywhere. You want to help someone, you have Excel skills, you can help them.
I need to go vacuum, otherwise mom is going to get angry and won't give me anything, any money, any allowance.
Out the computer, it's just logging, heating up.
Well, it's not a good thing. Why did you get
it? Can you just log in? Can you just log off and shut it down? You're struggling hard.
Because of the temperature.
Huh?
It's 98 degrees, and so the fans are it's in high thermal mode, and the fans are spinning really fast.
Close it. Can you shut down?
The fans are spinning super fast.